See, first we see about element deletion. Element deletion. How we delete an element? Suppose, for example, delete an element 2 ohms exists between nodes 9 and 10. He has given a network like this. He has given a network like this. See, having 9, 10 and reference bus. He is asking, here also element is there which is of 2 ohms. 3 ohms. Okay. He is asking in the network, delete an element 2 ohms between 9 and 10. I have to delete this element. So here I want to delete this element. How will delete? So deletion means what? It is, I want to make here open circuit. If I delete an element, what is Z value? It is infinity or not? I have to take open circuit. It is open circuit. Okay, open circuit means it is here. So here I am taking Z. Here I am connecting another one more element. Another element ZX here. Here I am connecting ZX across 9 and 10 element. Parallel combination of these two will be infinity or not? This is what I want to delete this 2 ohms element. So here I will add an element ZX. Having an impedance of ZX, parallel combination of these two will be infinity, such that it will be open circuited. So parallel combination of these two will be infinity. So we are getting impedance of what? Minus 2 ohms. So in order to open circuit this one, connect an impedance of minus 2 ohms across 9 and 10 buses so that the element 2 ohms is deleted. In this way we are deleting the element. Okay. This is element deletion. Be remember that minus 2 ohms is does not exist. For example, I am saying this one is. Element deletion is doing like this one only. So adding an element, parallel combination of these two will be like this. Okay. Now second one. Element impedance change case. Element impedance change case. Now I have to change an impedance value of an element. See here. The element having an impedance of 2 ohms has changed to 6 ohms. So the element 2 ohms between 9 and 10 has changed to 1.5 ohms. So here same network only. So the element which is present between 9 and 10 buses, which is of 2 ohms, I have to change that one into 1.5 ohms. This element change, element impedance change case. So I have to change the impedance of this element which is between 9 and 10 buses to 1.5 ohms. So for doing this one, here I also am connecting an element. Connect an element with impedance ZS across 9 and 10. So here I am connecting an element which is of having ZS or ZX across 9 and 10 buses. So parallel combination of these two will be 1.5 or not? So ZS into 2 by ZS plus 2 is equal to what? 1.5. So it will be what? How much it is? It is 2 into ZS by ZS plus 2 is equal to 3 by 2, If you solve this one, you will get 4ZS is equal to 3ZS plus 6. So ZS will be 6 ohms. So suppose I'm connecting 6 ohms across 9 and 10 buses. So total impedance changes to 1.5 ohms or not? In this way, we are changing an impedance of an element which is connected between two buses. This is element deletion case. This is element impedance change case. Now we'll see how we will add the element. How we will add an element between nodes. So here, in any power system network, I can add an element in four ways. So see here, four ways. Element addition. Element addition. I can add an element to the power system network in four ways. So see here, four ways means, here I have a power system network like this. This is power system network I have. Okay. Having three nodes. 1, 2, 3. It is 2 ohms. Suppose 3 ohms and 4 ohms. So here. This is power system network. Here I want to add an element. I want to add an element in 4 ways. See here. We will see that 4 ways. So it is. See here. 4 ways we have to see. So. Now, I want to add an element, suppose this take it as reference bus. Take it as reference bus in the network. Okay. Now see, first one is I want to add another element at reference bus, which is having 3 ohms. I want to add an element at a reference bus, and it is creating a new node or not? It is creating a new node which is of what? Third node. Suppose if I add an element at the reference bus which is of 3 ohms, it is creating a new node. Right? It is creating a new node. Okay. See, be remember, if any element is added at the reference bus, if it is creating a new node, it is comes under type 1. Right? It is type 1. If any element is added at reference bus, if it is creating a new node like this, then it is comes under type 1. Okay? This is type 1. First way of I'm adding element. Now we'll see second case. I can add an element in second way as see here. Suppose I'm adding an element at first bus. And it is also creating a new node, say it as 4. Now here I am adding an element at bus 1, node 1. It is creating a new node, right? So it is creating a new node. So where I am adding element? At first bus, which is already existing in network or not? So it is what? Existing node. See, we remember that if you add an element at the already existing node or a already existing bus, if it is creating a new node, it is comes under type 2. Suppose say it has element impedance 6 ohms. So it is type 2. Getting or not? In first case, I am adding element at the reference bus. It is creating a new node. At reference bus I am adding. Or reference node or reference bus. So it is creating a new node. So I am taking it as type 1. If I add an element at the bus 1 only. Bus 1 is already existing bus, right? So it is creating a new node also. So this is comes under type 2. It is type 2. Okay. Now suppose see here. If I add an element between two already existing nodes. If I add an element between already existing two nodes. See here. See. It is existing node. Is this reference node? If I add an element, you are having one ohm, adding between what? At the reference node and already existing node, is it creating any new node? No, right? So, suppose if I add an element at the reference bus, if it is not creating any new node, this comes under type 3. This comes under type 3. Okay? If I add an element at the reference bus, an already existing bus, if it is not creating any new node, it comes under type 3. This third way of adding an element. Now suppose, if I add an element between already existing two nodes, see here, these two are already existing two nodes. If I add an element between already existing two nodes, suppose say it has impedance of 5 ohms. Okay, suppose if I add an element between already existing two nodes, that is 1 and 2 nodes, it is not creating a new node, so it comes under type 4. It is type 4. In this way, we are adding an element in these 4 ways. So, 4 ways are what? Now, we'll see. Now, we'll see that 4 ways. Type 1. Type 1 means what? It is type 1. Adding an element at the reference node and new node. Element addition. At reference node, and new node. We take it as between. Element addition between reference node and new node. New node, I am taking it as Q, for example. Reference node means what? It is 0. Reference node is 0. Okay? So, this comes under type 1. Next. Type 2 is what? Adding an element at already existing node, and it is creating a new node. Element addition between what? Already existing node, and it is creating a new node. A new node. I am taking new node as Q, already existing node as K. Now, type 3. What is type 3? Adding an element between at the reference node and already existing node. It is not creating a new node. Element addition between reference node and existing node. We remember here new node is not created. Here two cases new node is created. If the node is created, what happens? Size will, suppose previously Zbus is having n by n size. After adding an element, if it is creating a new node, then size it changes to what? It is n plus 1 by n plus 1. So, it is Zbus new. Okay? So, if it is not creating a new node, same method of same size. Okay? Now, we'll see type 4. Element addition between what? Two already existing nodes. Here also node is not created. So size will be of what? Previous size, that is n by n. So Zbus new is also having same size, because here no new node is not created, so size of Zbus is same, it is not changed. But in type 1 and type 2 node is created, so changes to n plus 1 by n plus 1. Now we'll see how we will add an element in type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4. Okay? Now we'll discuss these 4 types.